Oh, hello there. It's me, Farmstead Guy, and I'm doing some hunting. So, without further ado, let's take a look at some decks.
And here's the first deck. Player name is Kalle. And I think he and Magnus de Laval was the founders of Old School. I think they was the two first people who started playing it. And this deck is insane. let's start in the sideboard. You can see there are two giant sharks there. So we have one Noobcon two times. So a double shark holder. I think earlier he used to play... He's famous for playing 4-drops. Fellow of Stone into 4-drop. I think he played Urnams and Suchis before. But looks like he's switched to white. With a Serra Angel and a... the good white removal, and this deck is all black border. There are signs and altars. Yeah, this deck is fantastic. All the good cards. So yeah, that was the deck. And here's the second deck. Player name is Goethe, and he is bringing a mono black aggro deck. It has the usual suspects. There are Black Knights and Hypnotic Spectres and two Strong Trunk Devils. And for the big creatures there are Suchi and Jusam Jin and a Senja Vampire. Sinkholes, Dark Rituals for Ramping and Underworld Dreams. Icy Manipulator and a single Royal Assassin. Yeah, so a fantastic black deck. Of course not that insanely blinged out like the previous one, but yeah, this is also cool. So let's see how this goes. Game number one. You have Goethe on the top and Kalle on the bottom. Goethe is on the play. Starts out with a swamp. An island and a Mox Ruby. And into a Chaos Orb. And a Mox Pearl activating it. Okay, and he doesn't have to flip. So that's a way to use a Chaos Orb. You can just take a chance that your opponent kept a hand with a few lands. Ooh, and a very strong follow-up here with a turn 2 Serra Angel. Oh, and a Maze. That's perfect. And now you wish you had the Chaos Orb to get that Maze. Oh wow, and a Time Twister. Talk about an explosive start here from Kalle. So they'll do some shuffling. But yeah, taking out that swamp is of course a bit risky, but if he has few lands, you can just win the game right there. So I don't hate that play at all. And sometimes it comes down to your read on your opponent. Perhaps the way he was organizing his cards, for example. Or if he did any mulligans. Ooh, and here's an Underworld Dream. Then there's a clock. Kalle goes down to 18. Oh, a library. And looks like it's he has 7 cards, so we can tap it right away and go up to 8 cards. So it's going to be huge card advantage here. Let's see if Goethe has any of those sinkholes. I think he had them in his deck. Ooh, and another Serra Angel. Four mana for Suchi. at least Kalle can now do some damage with those Sarah Angels. A Lotus. Icy Manipulator. That's cool. So now he can tap down that mace and attack for 8. Wow. So Gaute is down to 12. And that's a 3 turn clock. So he needs to find some answers for at least one of the angels. Is going to attack. Let's see, tapping 3 mana for a Hypnotic Spectre. And I think he should have attacked there. Because that Tsuchi can't block those flying angels. Wow, copy artifact on the Icy Manipulator. So now Kalle can tap down 2 permanents. So at least, so he takes taps down the Hypnotic Spectre as well. Just trying to do as much damage as possible. Puts Gaute down to 4, but he can attack with that Hypnotic next turn. Oh, and that's a Fireball for 4. Perfect. Game number 2. Looks like Kalle is mulliganing to 6. Gaute is on the play. There's a swamp. And a beautiful volcanic island from Beta, from Kalle. Gotta mention that. Those are pretty expensive. Is there a... Yes, there's a Lightning Bolt. Of course, signed by Christopher Rush and altered. That is pretty cool as well. Yeah, all the cards in this deck is pretty... is awesome. But when you got in early on this format, it was much cheaper. So Hypnotic Spectre and that eats at a bolt. Tapping 4 mana. Ooh, he has an Icy Manipulator as well. Tapping 2 blue. What could that be? It's a mana drain. So now Kalle has a 4 colorless mana in his first main phase. Looks like he has some options. Yeah. 4 lands and 4 colorless. There's an Icy, and he uses the mana drain mana to pay for it. And his opponents look a bit confused, but yes, there's the mana drain. Okay, and he taps down 1 swamp. That is smart. 3 mana for a Royal Assassin. Such a cool card. Oh, that, when I started, that was like the best card ever. And there was a local guy who had a deck with 4 Royal Assassin and 4 Icy Manipulators. And that deck was considered unbeatable. But In modern old school, Royal Assassin isn't that good, but he's still cool and awesome, so I like to see him. Okay, so Kalle is looking through his library, so I guess there was a demonic tutor. Yeah, there it is. Will there be an ancestral? A new dream from Goethe. Okay. I wonder what Kalle found with that demonic tutor. Two mana here for a disenchant. Okay, I don't think that was the card he found. Because normally, when someone casts a demonic tutor, you'll see an ancestral right away. But Kalle is keeping it cool and taking his time. He's under no pressure, so it's fine to do that. And his deck is of course has a bit higher power level than his opponent. There's another Underworld Dream, and there's an altered counter spell. Beautiful. Chaos Orb. And yes, that is also an altered one. Ooh, a disc. Okay, so Kalle is activating his Chaos Orb to take care of the disc, and we'll go to use it in... Now the disc was tapped, so he can't use it. There's a mind twist for two. Okay, taking care of a terror and a... What's that called? Obliette or something? And a the third Underworld Dream. So Kalle is down to 15. Tapping two mana for Fellowo Stone. Not attacking with that Royal Assassin. And there's a maze. So I'm recording this early in the morning, so I need some coffee. I'll try not to slurp that much. And a mind twist. Oh, that's huge. Is there a counter spell or anything? Looks like you're thinking about casting something. Is there some burn cards, perhaps? Ooh, there was a psionic blast, but he didn't want to cast it. Serra Angel, a balance, a lot of good stuff. I don't know why Goat isn't attacking with that Royal Assassin, but perhaps they just have an agreement that Kalle is going to tap it. Strip mine on the volcanic island. Not sure if it perhaps would have been better to just wait in case Kalle draws a factory or something, because he has a lot of mana. Ooh, a fireball takes care of two creatures. Always great to have that one-off fireball. And here's a gloom. So we sided in gloom, apparently. And the fourth underworld rim. Okay, so gloom isn't that good this late in the game. Kalle has a 7 mana, so if we get one more mana, he can still cast his Serra Angels. Okay. Oh, he was that low on life. Okay, I forgot to pay attention to the life loss due to the underworld dreams. So suddenly it was a 2 and it was dead. So now we have a game 3. And that's a turn 1 Chaos Orb. Okay, Dark Ritual into a Gloom. So Gloom is great if you have a lot of pressure on the table and can do a lot of attacking, because eventually your opponent is going to have enough mana to cast Disenchant and Sword Plowshares and all that. Ooh, and there's a Tsuchi, an altered one, signed by Christopher Rush, who is not with us anymore. So that's a very rare signature. Attacking with a Tsuchi. An Icy Manipulator. Okay, Goethe casting a disc. That's a good card here. Let's see if there's any Disenchant from Kalle. Tapping 5 mana. 6 mana. A Brain Geyser for 4. Okay, that's a good way to get some card advantage. Because it looks like that disc is going to clear the table. Is activated. Oh yeah, here's Jusam. And he's a 5/5, so he's very good in this matchup, because Kalle's big creatures is Serra Angel and Tsuchi. And here's a Tsuchi. Oh boo, Sword to Plowshare. 1 mana, such a good card. But that's the thing in old school. You have awesome removal and pretty bad creatures. Okay, so attacking with a Tsuchi. And the Goethe makes it a 4/4, but in response to the last activation, when it's a 3/3 and he's tapping his second factory to make it a 4/4, Kalle respond with casting a lightning bolt and doing 3 damage. And here's a Serra Angel and a Tarot. Another Gloom. That's not what you want to see this late in the game. I go a bit back and forth about Gloom. I feel like it's pretty bad, but it's been used to great effect in those robot BB-8 decks. But they are really fast. Okay, so the factory is trading. Is it doing 4 damage, but I go down to 9. There's a maze. That will slow the bleeding down. Still attack for 2 with the factory. Oh, there comes something big. Ooh, an 8 mana Sarah Angel, so we can pay for that gloom effect. And another gloom. So the next Sarah Angel will cost 11. So the maze stops the angel, do 6 damage with the rest. And is there anything? Strip mine and a scoop. GG. So Kalle won 2-1. And yeah, that was a great match. And but that Gloom card, that's kind of hard to play with. Because if you have Gloom in your sideboard and your opponent has white cards like Kalle does, is it right to bring it in? Because I like it if you have can just play like a turn 1 Suchi or something really aggressive and then play a Gloom and then you get a bit more time before your opponent's white removal can start taking care of your creatures. But Gauta's deck is pretty aggressive. He has the Dark Ritual. He can curve out with a Stone Throwing Devil into Black Knight, into Hypnotic, Suchi, Jusam, Sanjir. That deck could be really aggressive. So yeah, I'm just trying to learn. So let me know in the comment, eh? And that was it for me today. You should like this video. You should subscribe if you haven't. And make a comment. I love those. So thank you for watching. Goodbye.